Hello, and welcome back to Route 85, our road trip of knowledge for iOS developers, where we don't have rest stops, we have breakpoints. And part three on our little series on opening a link in Chrome on iOS. Now, as you recall from last time, which you should watch if you haven't yet, we were able to open a link from our app directly in Google Chrome and add a button in Chrome that goes back to our app using this giant URL that takes advantage of the x-callback-url format. But there's one little problem here. It turns out that if you have a very old version of Chrome, like you haven't updated it in over 2 years, and you tried to open this URL, it wouldn't work. You see, Chrome didn't add support for the x-callback-url spec until like November of 2012. But because this URL still begins with the Google Chrome scheme, our UI application's canOpenURL method would evaluate to true, or yes. It's only once our old version of Chrome receives this URL that it barfs. So we have no way of knowing whether or not our version of Chrome is recent enough to handle this x-callback-url. Or do we? Dun dun dun! You see, what the Google Chrome team did, which I think is kind of clever, is they added a third URL scheme called Google Chrome x-callback. This was added at the same time that the team added support for x-callback-url, which means that you can check and see if Google Chrome supports x-callback-url by asking if it can open a URL that begins with the Google Chrome x-callback scheme. Now, if it can't, then that's okay, you just revert back to the basic Google Chrome URL. But if it can, then you just pass in the full URL as is. So let's go back to our sample application here and put this into action. Here I am back in my viewcontroller.m file. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to change my callback URL so that instead of beginning with Google Chrome S, it's going to begin with Google Chrome -x -callback. I'm running out of space here, so let's put this on another line. Great. And so now I have three URLs that I can use. I've got my callback URL for modern versions of Chrome, my basic Chrome URL for fairly old versions of Chrome, and my plain old Safari URL. So now let's go into my if clause here. So first I'm going to check and see, can I open my fancy callback URL? If I can, then I know my version of Chrome supports the x-callback URL scheme and can therefore handle this URL that points back to my application. If it can't, then I'm going to add another check here and see, well, can you at the very least, can you open the URL that is my Chrome URL? If so, then I know that I have a version of Chrome installed, albeit a fairly old one, but still I can have my UI application, shared application, open URL, Chrome URL. And otherwise, if it can't open either of those, then I know I don't have Chrome installed at all, and I will fall back to Safari. So there we go. If we open this app again on my device, we can see that clicking on this button will bring up Chrome. And the fact that Chrome has this back button pointing back to my app means that we passed along the X callback version of the URL and not the basic Chrome one. And that's because I have a version of Chrome that is less than 2 years old. I actually can't show you this working on a really old version of Chrome. I'm not quite sure where to get it, but I guess you'll just have to trust me that would work too. So this is all fine and dandy, but I have now expanded my simple code to open a URL from like one or two lines to like, what, 12? And we did a bunch of manual URL escaping in the process. So it seems like I probably want to abstract this logic out into a separate class or something, right? Well, as luck would have it, Google has already done the work for us. So let's take a look at that next. So let's go visit the OpenInChrome GitHub page over at github.com/googlechrome/openinchrome. Now you can go ahead and grab these files however you'd like. You can download the zip or clone the repository locally. I think I am just going to grab the zip file here. Do, do, do. And then once it's done, I'm going to open up my zip file. And within here are the two files you're going to need, OpenInChrome.h and OpenInChrome.m. So I'm just going to drag these two directly into my project in Xcode here. I'm going to say, yes, let's copy these. And you can go ahead and check out these files if you want. If you've been following these lessons up until this point, most of this code should look pretty familiar to you. They're just being a little more robust and a little more bulletproof than our sample code. So go ahead and check these out. You can check out, most importantly, the .h file, which is the actual public interface of this class. You can see that basically it's a singleton. We have a nice Boolean, is Chrome installed, and we can either open a URL in Chrome or open a URL in Chrome with a callback URL. So let's go back to my view controller here and go back to my open in web page method. And basically, let's just delete all of this. All that hard work, gone. So I'm going to go ahead and define two URLs here. The first is the URL that I actually want to open. We'll call it page to open. It'll be an NS URL, URL with string. And this can be just a plain old URL that opens up www.google.com. Then let's add a second URL, which is our callback URL. And this is going to be com Google open in Chrome example colon end quotes. Again, note the colon at the end there, and clearly you should make this specific to your app. Now the code to open this up is much simpler. First, let me go ahead and import my OpenInChromeController.h. And I'm just going to add an if clause that says if OpenInChromeController shared instance is Chrome installed. Well, if that's the case, then let's just open it in Chrome. And I can do that by calling the method OpenInChromeController shared instance, open in Chrome. For this URL, I'm going to make it the page to open. With callback URL can be our callback URL. And create a new tab, it's probably not necessary. So we'll say no here. Format this nicely. And otherwise, user doesn't have Chrome installed. So we'll just fall back to opening up this link in Safari. And this is our plain old UI application, shared application, open URL method. And the nice thing here is that the open in Chrome controller is doing all the heavy lifting in converting my ordinary URL into an X callback URL with all that percent escaped information all over the place. In fact, let's go into this controller here and we'll add a little NSLog statement that shows what URL it actually ends up trying to open. So right here, I'm going to add a little NSLog that says, I am attempting to open, and we'll look at our Chrome URL absolute string. So we can give this a try now by running it. And just like always, I have a button. I can click on it, takes me into Chrome, and there's a back button that once again takes me back to my application. And we go back to our console and we look at what's been generated here. We can see that, yes, it has taken our very simple URL and converted it into the giant X callback URL that is required to open this in Chrome with the back button. So we'll stop this. And so now I'm sure you can see we have some logic that is really easy to convert to a more general purpose method, right? Now, maybe in a real application, when the user starts up the app, you can check and see if they have Chrome installed. If they do have Google Chrome installed, then maybe the first time the user clicks on a link, you could bring up an alert view or an action sheet that lets them select their default browser. Save that information in NS User Defaults, remember that choice in the future, and then you could write a simple open URLs in preferred browser method that takes a URL and makes the appropriate call to open it. And there you go. I now have an application that opens up links in the user's browser of choice, whatever it might be. Oh, and in case you're wondering, do extensions in iOS 8 make this entire system obsolete? The answer would appear to be no. iOS 8 does support a number of actions with extensions, and I suspect that there are some use cases of URL schemes that could now be better handled by extensions. However, opening up a web page isn't currently one of them. So now at this point, we're basically done with our main goal of showing you how to open up a link in Chrome on iOS, but we can still have a little more fun with that X callback URL and see how we can take advantage of the link that Chrome is using to send the user back to our app. And I'll show you how to do that in the next lesson, so stay tuned.